every day when we wear the blood of Jesus upon us, wherever we go, it will be speaking to God. It will be speaking to the enemy, get away from me. This child is mine. Don't dare to come near. Blood of Jesus directly attacks the enemy, and the enemy has a bond of what are the sin we have done and what are the punishment we are supposed to receive. And the blood of Jesus takes the bond from Satan and tears and throws them into pieces. And the enemy is having the chain to bind us, and he takes away the chains and binds the enemy and makes us to walk with him in a victorious life. So the blood of Jesus has that power. So every day we wear this helmet of salvation, what God has done to me through his blood, what God has done to me through his word. So I take the helmet of salvation. A servant of God whose name is Brother Augustine, one of my neighbors, he is working in a place called Bihar. He narrates one of the incidents in his speech. He says, once an orphan girl was given to Brother Augustine's wife. So Brother Augustine's wife brought that girl up nicely. Then suddenly the girls came and reported that though she eats so well, night time she disappears and goes and eats the food, the waste food that is thrown. She goes there and eats. Then Augustine's wife, she says, what's wrong? You are already eating every day and your stomach is becoming bigger and bigger. Why are you eating like this? And the next day onwards, Augustine's wife made her to sit with her, eat as much as you want, eat as what all the things you want. But then night time, she told the friends, now all of you have to carefully watch over her. You are in charge. The next day morning, they come and say, her name is Geeta, auntie, we were all holding her hand and sleeping, but when we were sleeping, 12 o'clock, she left our hand and she went away. Where did she go? To the food that was thrown away. And there she sits and collects and eats. What to do? Then Augustine's wife said, now I will take care of her. So she kept her in her bed and locked the latch and slept, because she goes to preach the word of God and comes tired going to the village. This girl at night slowly leaves the hands up. Augustine's wife puts the stool, climbs over the stool, removes the latch, goes out to eat that. Now they did not know what to do with this girl. With our studies, we can have knowledge, but only Holy Spirit can give us revelation. Nobody can give. That's why the Bible says, the youngsters, yuvakulu alasi solasi povudru, le prayam varu padipovudru, kani prabhuni nammina varu, nutana balamunu, nutana jeevamunu pondi, pakshi rajuvale, paiki paiki varu eguruduru. The book of Isaiah chapter 40 verse 30 onwards. It is only those who wait on the Lord, they receive the revelation of the Lord. We have to wait on him. Lord, I am here. I am here. I am waiting for you. What shall I do? So Augustine's wife started to pray, fast and pray. And one day as she was praying, she had a vision. She saw Geeta. And in that, the Lord showed to give the key of the fridge. She could not understand why fridge. And then the Lord revealed to her. Next day, she called Geeta. Geeta, come, look at the fridge. The rice is here, dal is here, chicken is here, everything is here. Whenever and I lock it, keep the key with you. Now you open, she open and so. Now you know how to open. Now you lock, lock it, okay. Now keep the key with you. Whenever you feel like eating, you open that, eat whatever you want. So it seems her friends were telling, when she was sleeping, suddenly she will get up and she will see the key. My key is with me. She will go to sleep. She will feel like eating. That mind thought will come. Go, get up and go and eat the dirt. She will get up and she will see the key. Oh, I have the food with me. She will sleep. And that evil thought disappeared with the thought that you have something always for you. The same way, any evil thought comes, immediately you have to wear the helmet of salvation. You have the blood of Jesus. Even though the evil thought has come, God is with you. He died for you. He paid the price for you. He has loved you. You are not an ordinary guy. You are bought for a price. And reflect on the cross. How much he was hit. He was scourged. Scourging means what? In every handle, there will be 8 branches. And each branch, there will be 3 or 4 small branches. In that, the bones, the stones, and the hard metals will be there. So when they hit on you, the flesh will come out. If you are a Romans, you can receive only 39. But Jesus was not a Roman citizen. So he received until he fell, until they were satisfied. Yes. He went through humiliation for you and me. And it is that blood gave him the energy to carry the cross. So you and I, whenever the thought of evil comes, whenever the thought of temptation comes, whenever the thought of any evil attack of the enemy comes, immediately you remember the chavi, the blood. Yes, blood is upon me. What my Savior did for me. What my Savior to shed his blood, how he went through humiliation. Get into the helmet of salvation. Take it and put it on you. And the enemy will disappear. The more you remember, I explained to you what is the meaning of helmet of salvation. 5 things. And you remember all that. And it is through which the enemy, you can overcome the enemy. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes. It is on the cross. Jesus prayed for you and me. My Father, forgive them. Because forgiveness is base for protecting us from the enemy. You have an injection which protects you. Insulin you have. That protects you that you don't fall because of your sugar. You have the insulin that keeps you in balance. But that insulin has to be kept up in a proper way. It has to be kept on the fridge. If you don't have it, it will spoil. It will lose its effect. In the same way, the blood of Jesus will begin to operate in us when we have follow certain procedure. What is that? Jesus said in Luke's Gospel chapter 11, he taught the disciples prayer and he said, if you forgive others, your sins will be forgiven. So without forgiving others, don't expect your God to forgive you. That's why in the book of Sirach chapter 28 verse 1 to 10 it is written, when you do not forgive others, how can you expect God to forgive you? When you want to keep up your own, when you want to keep up, remember others' mistakes and going on talking about others' mistakes, How can you expect God to forget your mistakes and forgive you? So be generous. Remember what will be your end. Even if somebody has done the worst thing, look at the cross, what he has done for you. Forgive them. Leave them into the hands of God. Let God take control. You know, when you leave into the hands of God, now it is God's duty to do what they have done to you. Yes, that's what the Bible says. Let not the evil conquer you, but conquer the evil by good. Romans 12:21. So forgive one another, whereby God can forgive you. At the same time, if you don't forgive others, don't expect God to forgive you. That's why Jesus cried on the cross, my Father, please forgive them, for they do not know what this blood of mine means to them. They do not know what is goodness and kindness. He prayed and cried to the Father.